Well, not a day passes when someone on the left doesn't call the president a dictator. But for some, because they're against dictators, but for some reason, they don't have much to say about China, home of actual dictators, a country whose human rights record remains atrocious, even as it grows more powerful economically. In the far west of China, as many as a million Muslims have been detained in concentration camps, while Beijing has used restrictive laws and the mass immigration of ethnic Chinese to the region to stamp out their native culture. Christians, meanwhile, and other faiths face repression as well, but big tech and other American companies who do business in China don't seem to care at all. They're happy to profit from all of this. Senator Marco Rubio is one of the very few lawmakers who does care. We recently talked to him about it. Senator, that's a remarkable number. A million Chinese Muslims in camps.
Right.
Because the Chinese government cracks down on them because of their religion. Why, A, is that true? And B, why don't we hear more about it?
It's absolutely true. In fact, one of the outrages here is Google Earth. Pictures from Google Earth show us these camps. And so we read these reports about Google looking to partner up with China again, going back to China. But it's their own pictures that have revealed this reality to the world. They open these places up. They call them re-education camps, where they're basically forcing people to change their names and do all sorts of things. By the way, there's no history of radicalism among this community of Uyghurs. That's the first point. But here's the outrage. Number one, American companies and Western companies that have sold them surveillance technology that have allowed them to sort of put people through some of this, including an American DNA company. They're collecting the DNA of these individuals, by the way, as well, forcefully, and using potentially American technology to do it. And what about the Arab world and the Muslim world and all these countries in the Middle East? Not a single one of them. You know, they're the first to stand up and speak when there's a ban on travel or this or that. But they've been totally silent on this issue. And the answer is money. There's all this Chinese money flowing all over the world. They're bribing governments and, in this case, buying their silence on this atrocious, outrageous human rights violations that give us insight into the true nature of the regime of President Xi in China.
That is remarkable. So the government of Saudi Arabia, government of Egypt, two of the largest Arab governments in the world, they have not pressured China to stop cracking down on Muslims?
In fact, it's not mentioned at all in international forums either. Last week, finally, for the first time, they were confronted with it, and the Chinese were forced to answer some questions by an international organism, but not by some of these countries, many of whom have said very little of anything. And if they've said it, it's been very benign, nothing forceful. In essence, if there were a million people of any religion being rounded up anywhere in the world by a Western nation, I assure you, you would be hearing all about it, and rightfully so. But in this case, because these countries have leaders, many of whom have either taken bribes from the Chinese or that there's Chinese investment involved and promises of more money to come, they've been able to buy their silence. Hypocrisy, outrageous, unacceptable. And I'm glad that this administration is looking into doing something about it.
But you often hear Democratic lawmakers, including in your body, the Senate, stand up and say this administration is mistreating Muslims. They haven't said anything about this. Why?
Well, I think there's a general lack of awareness, the first is. The second, I think, we talked about this before on your program, and I'm glad you pay so much attention to it. A significant percentage of the American people are starting to wake up to the reality that for the first time since 1991, we have a near-peer competitor in the world, and that's China. They don't seek to compete with us, they seek to overtake us, to replace us in the world. And sadly, we still have American corporations and companies that are so interested in doing business and making money in China that they don't care about it. So you have tech companies that won't partner with the Pentagon on defense projects, but partner with the Chinese university that works for their military and who want us to cave on. I call the president at least once a week and just continue to encourage him because it's the first time any administration has finally stood up to China after years and years of abuse and looking the other way.
Senator, thanks for all the work you've done on this. I appreciate it.
Thank you for the attention you pay to this issue.